At least 103 Falun Gong practitioners died in China last year after they were tortured. This, according to the U.S.-based Falun Gong information website Minghui.org. Falun Gong is a spiritual practice rooted in Chinese tradition. It features five slow-moving meditative exercises and is guided by the principles of truthfulness, compassion, and tolerance. Two decades ago, the Chinese Communist Party launched a campaign against the practice, and millions have been detained, tortured, and killed in China since then. Here are the stories of just a few of the practitioners who lost their lives to the persecution last year. Liu Xiyong died last month at age 80. Liu is from northeastern China's Liaoning province. He was already 77 when he was sentenced to 3 years in prison in 2018. That's because he had been trying to expose the communist regime's persecution of the meditation practice. After he was released last year, he was again sentenced to another 4 years in prison. Liu became seriously ill in prison due to his mistreatment. But because he refused to denounce his faith, he was refused temporary release for medical treatment. He died in December 2021, when he was 80. Another Falun Gong practitioner, Lü Songming from Hunan province, was sentenced three times for a combined total of 14 years in prison because he refused to give up his faith. In prison, they suspended his body with ropes for many hours at a time, and he was beaten with an electric baton. His teeth fell off after he was injured and was left with only six teeth on his release. He was tortured until he had severe heart failure and died in March last year at the age of 53. Liu had been a school teacher and a Courage Award recipient before the regime began persecuting Falun Gong practitioners in 1999. According to Minghui, similar incidents have been recorded in every province and region across the country.